This is our BioNano lab. Essentially what we do here is we do microfluidics. Some of the chips that we're making here for microfluidics, specifically for the purpose of sorting, are essentially a set of pillar arrays. And what you're seeing here is you're seeing sort of a diffraction sort type effect. These have not quite been prepped yet, so they have kind of a rainbow effect to these. The idea here is that we want to flow fluid through these chips, and that could be ultimately a human sample, either whether a blood sample or a urine sample, something like that that you could use for a diagnostic purposes. And we're going to separate out the materials within those samples with very, very fine resolution to a scale that's sort of been unprecedented. While a lot of people are sorting sort of cells on chip, we're kind of sorting at a scale of 2 to 3 orders of magnitude below that limit, to where we're really in the true nanoscale, separating interesting materials like exosomes, DNA, protein, etc. One of the thing that lab on a chip type idea that we're going to put several of the capabilities inside a traditional wet lab, and we're going to put those on a chip. This is one of the chips that we've made here in a stack configuration where we've actually bonded the chips, and we've got several large-scale nanoDLD arrays that we've created. After we've fabricated the chips and we've diced them up, we need to mount those. We need a way to interface with the outside world. So we do some glass bonding processes. That glass has ports in the surface. Those chips are then mounted within some fluidic jigs. After we have the chips mounted in the jig, we'll take that over to our fluorescence microscope. At that point, we can start to pump fluids onto the chip at a set velocity. Particles that we're separating currently are roughly 1/10,000th of a human hair. This is the size scale of the nanoscale range. This is the microelectronics research laboratory here at IBM T.J. Watson Research Center. This is where we make the wafers. This is where we make all the devices, everything from solar cells to superconducting devices to state-of-the-art computer chips. 90% or 95% of the contamination that's out there that can potentially ruin a microelectronic device comes from humans. And so we wear these bunny suits, as they're called, that make sure that the dust gets taken off where we enter the door to go in. Some of the innovations that have occurred in the microelectronics industry, those breakthroughs have been made right here in this building. So essentially what we're doing is we're combining all of that expertise in all of these different areas and combining it in unique ways that's beneficial for healthcare, such as our microfluidic chips, for example.